Alrighty, hey kiddos, welcome back to another episode of Amnesia, The Dark Descent. I know, for those of you who are watching this on Twitch, it's not nighttime yet. It's only like 5 o'clock. That's okay though. I got my curtains closed, so I guess the mood is there. Anyways, yep, we're here. This is the control room for something. I think the water. I'm not quite sure yet. This chair is stuck in the ground. Okay, whatever. I remember that this is a puzzle I got stuck on last time, so I'm not quite sure what to do, but I'll figure it out, I guess. I remember these pipes, though. I gotta do something with these. Well, I can just tell by those laying on the ground. Puzzle. How do you keep the gate open? Simple, just block it. There we go. Yeah, this was the puzzle I got stuck on. I didn't know what to do here. Another pipe. This is where the pipes go. I figured that out. Thank you. I love the lighting in this game. Have I said that already? I love the lighting in this game. Okay, what does these do? I'm supposed to repeat what this is. That maybe? Something. I'm doing something. What am I doing? I'm trying to solve a puzzle. And I don't know the answer. Crank for a machine. I'm supposed to just keep turning until I hear a click. Maybe I already solved the answer. I think I already did it. I think I already did everything. I'm just wandering around aimlessly. I already finished the puzzle. That worked. Yeah, so basically I was stuck and I didn't need to be. Interesting.
You're concerned with water from the spring.
Yes, it enables me to control the water in the drain sewers to some extent. Also, it can be used for all sorts of purposes.
Like for drinking?
Well, that too. But mostly to run different machines.
Ah, like water mill.
Exactly.
Yeah, but I know for a fact there's a monster down here. Check this out. Oh, never mind, it just hurt when I landed in the water. Parkour. Hell yeah. Parkour. Yep.
of August, 1839. There is no denying that Alexander puts a lot of faith into what I can only describe as magic. I'm not surprised. Even while traveling across Europe, I assumed I would have to embrace the supernatural to save my mind and life. As a novice, I do everything in my power to stay focused and not dwell too much on my own doubts. Alexander woke me up early and told me it was time we got started on our work. He was obviously excited to get going, and we headed downstairs to the old dungeon, where he preferred to attempt his rituals. It turns out that Alexander is a true Renaissance man, paralleled only by Da Vinci, I'm sure. He showed me several rooms fitted for specific research, such as anatomy studies, alchemy, and botany. The crown of Brennenburg must be the inner sanctum, a most hallowed ground, where we shall attempt to permanently banish the orb's shadow.
Oh, that can't be good. I mean, I don't think I'm gonna run into any monsters except for a water one. Oh, I can hear somebody in there. Is there something I could throw? Rock. Nice! I'm gonna keep this rock with me. This is gonna be my rock.
August 1839. I could never be certain until today that I was on the right path. Using my orb, Alexander managed to channel its power unto us. The inner sanctum flared with blue, fiery light, and I could feel the same things I felt in the dark chamber in Algeria. It was like standing in a mad whirlpool of impressions. It was terrifying. But Alexander kept calm and wielded strange tools of science in order to tame the storm. Suddenly, the blue light was stained by strains of red, and the walls burst with pulsating tissue resonating with the scene. Alexander quickly covered the orb in some cloth, and the unspeakable thing vanished. Apparently, the orb's shadow is closer than Alexander thought. He said I should prepare for a warding ritual tomorrow. I'm not sure what he expects, but I have a bad feeling about this.
Well, luckily I still have my rock. Go over there! No?
August 1839. It is still early, and Alexander is busy preparing for the ritual later today. Seeing him this worked up makes me question why. What does he stand to gain? I realize he is curious about it all, but surely there must be more. Is he so foolish he will attempt to tame the power of the orb? I must admit that yesterday, when Alexander flooded the inner sanctum with blue light, I realized we had but graced the orb's true potential. This might turn out to be more than escaping a creeping shadow. It might be the beginning of something truly extraordinary.
Well, that just turned off the steam. Is that a fish? I can fix it. I can move this now. Is that all I had to do, really? Throw something on top of it. There we go.
Do you see, Daniel? It has yielded. Let's get this out of here so we can get some peace.
Yes, let's. Where to?
Just down the corridor, to the morgue.
Are there more dead men there?
You did well, Daniel. Come, let's get going.
My heavenly father will take me in my sleep.
trying to see if they'll say anything else. I made a syringe. That is a lot of naked people.
Just like Regent's Park.
Oh, I didn't know I needed to do that. I just imagined I wouldn't be able to get the syringe in first. I guess I knew. Huh. Oh, that's not fun. That dude sounds a lot bigger. He doesn't sound bigger, he just sounds... My brain's crying. I think he's gone. I think that was the one-hit monster, chat. Because there's a monster in this game that can one-shot kill you. Well, that got me down fast. Oh, is this where the fun guy is? And I'm out of the water. It's just like that, Chet. The water monster's on the other side of this wall. I don't care though, I'm gonna hide up here for a second. You know what I'd use to describe Amnesia? It's not terrifying, it's nerve-wracking. Thank you. Amnesia isn't scary because of, like, jump scares. It's, like, nerve-wracking. That's how I would describe amnesia. That's why I like it, though. I have anxiety, so, you know. I don't handle this shit easy. You could see it if I had a webcam, but I don't. My brain likes to play tricks on me. This area is not that bad, if I'm being honest. Looking for something I can throw. Sounds like it's slower. I definitely did something right, because they sent the monster after me. Oh, that's the fucking... the grunt!
Daniel, turn around this instant. You are carrying the shadow with you.
Yeah, I'm gonna carry him with me. I don't know if I'm gonna name him, but I'm gonna carry him with me, just in case I need to throw him at somebody. Now what? I feel like I won't be able to outrun it, but I might as well try. Buddy, I'm gonna take your arm with you, just in case I need to throw it at him. I killed one of them by throwing something at him. Who knows what I'll do this time? Where's he at? Yeah, he one-shot kills me. Okay, now I know. Run. Thank you. Thank you for that. Oh, they just get rid of them. They just despawn them. That's not fun. Well, I guess I'm gonna see him again soon anyways, so it doesn't matter. I escaped. I mean, I died, but I escaped.
Ninth of August, 1839. I can't stop sweating and shaking. The warding ritual was not something of a sane mind. I did not even realize the dungeon was still in use. Alexander had his servants bring one of the prisoners, a murderer, he told me. Alexander made all the arrangements, but he said I had to perform the ritual in order to have the right effect. The shadow could be led astray by the blood of another. Killing the man would provide us precious time. What else could I do? Alexander said it had to be done. He is saving my life. I don't have the luxury of argument.
So I can imagine you killed a lot of people then, huh, Daniel? This is where I run out of light a lot, so I need to be careful with my light here. That's why I have a whole bunch of tinderboxes. There we go. At least I'll be able to see. I'll lose a tiny bit of sanity, but that shouldn't be a problem.
Awake. Can you feel the syringe?
No. I can't feel anything, Alexander.
Yes.
Soon, I won't even be able to move, will I?
your life is safe.
I don't doubt that. But will it be worth living? Alexander? Oh my, so Babylon shall fall, you say. You've hurried too much. Alexander is toothless without an oar.
He has one.
That's not very promising, though. The Cyclone is basically impenetrable, but guess why more? It could be breached by another, but Alexander broke his. I mean, my own, a long time ago.
Really?
Then if you tell the truth, by all means, seek out the pieces of the broken oar and mend away. I believe he uses them for torture now. They practically leak matter, which is quite useful, I understand. There should be six of them. Look around the choir and the transept. You should be able to find them there.
Oh, we're in the end.
I hate to bother you further, but if you're really going after Alexander, would you consider taking me with you? I know it sounds ridiculous. I mean, look at him. But if you find anything concerning a man named Johann Heim, would you please bring it to me? I believe he is working on a way to help him. A recipe for some sort of potion, a tonic to free me from this husk of mine.
Anyways, I'll see you guys in the next episode, because it's been like an hour, and, you know, my episodes are usually only an hour long. Bye, kiddos!